Solvete omnes. I'm going to be going over the cases 2 worksheet today. So before we start, please go to Google Classroom and open up the worksheet cases 2 and go to the last section. Also take out your case chart so you can refer to that as we go through your work. All right. Now, you can, if you've already done it, you can use this to check, or if you want to do it right now, go ahead. You can stop the video whenever you need to like practice on your own and then see what I got. Okay. All right. So let's look here at the first sentence. Okay. Number 1, do you know about Tullius Hostilius and his life? We're really good in these sentences. We're going to focus on the endings of the nouns, the verb stuff. If you're still having difficulty on it, it's okay. We'll have other ways to practice it. All right. So the answer would be Scisne de Tullia Hostilia et Vita. Now your Latin that you write down is not going to be exactly like this because you probably said Tullius, Hostilius, Vita, things like that. So we're going to focus on those endings, and that's where the case chart comes in handy. Because Tullius, Hostilius are both second declension. But since you have the preposition de in front of it, they go ablative singular. So the us changes to an o. Now Vita keeps that a, but there's a long mark that's put on for it, so it sounds differently. And that goes to an ablative singular, but it's part of the group in the first declension. All right? All right, number 2. The third king in Rome was Tullius Hostilius. Now, this sentence is a little bit special because it has the verb was in it. And if you use any form of the verb to be, is, was, were, it really takes nominative on both sides. So when we write it out, it looks probably pretty similar to what you wrote already. We have Tertius Rex, Romae erat Tullius Hostilius. All these things, all these nouns, are second declension, nominative, singular. So they end in us. Now Rex here is a little weird because he's a third declension noun and it's nominative, singular. Now Romae, since you've been doing Duolingo, just means at Rome. So we're not going to really worry about that right now. Sentence number 3. This man had little piety and did not sacrifice in temples. So the sentence would look correct in the correct form and be hic vir parvam pietatem habuit et in templis non sacrificavit. Now vir, since that is the subject of the verb, it's the thing that has had. So this man had little piety. It's second declension, nominative singular, ends in an R. Now parvam is describing pietatem, which is feminine singular, and that's the direct object. So it'd be a first declension, accusative singular, while pietatem is a third declension noun, and that would be accusative singular as well, ending in em. Then we have here templis, at the in templis. Now in takes the ablative when you're saying location. So templis here is second declension, ablative, plural. Great. Let's look at the next one. Number 4. The king said to us, with great wars, we must make a great empire. Now, the first bit we probably got fairly right. We probably said Rex Nobis Dixit. Dixit's past tense is perfect. Then let's look at these nouns. We have magnis bellis, magnum imperium facere debemus. So magnis and bellies both end in is because it means with great wars. This is what many people would call an ablative of means, by means of great wars. And when you use a noun this way in Latin, it's going to be ablative plural. And since these things are second declension, they're going to end in is. Then we have here imperium and magnum. Now magnum imperium are the direct objects, the thing that you must make. We must make a big empire. So that would be a direct object. So that since they're both second declension, it'd be second declension, accusative, singular, ending in um. Now we look here at number 5. The Romans conquered many cities, many towns, and many people in Italy. So the sentence in Latin would be Romani multas urbes, multa opida, et multos homines in Italia winkerent or winkebot, depending on what form of the verb you want. Now, Romani, those are the subjects. Those are the people who are conquering. So the Romani here are second declension, nominative, plural. And then we have multas, urbes. Those are all accusative because that's the thing that's being conquered. It's direct object. So it's first declension, accusative plural. And then urbes are third declension. So it's third declension, accusative plural. And then multa, opida. Now it's also another thing that's being conquered. These are both second declension. Now these are neuter because they end in in the nominative. So the accusative plural would be opida. And we've seen this before, multa, opida. And then the last couple nouns we want to look at, we have multos. Now this is accusative. It's an adjective, so it's either first or second declension. Since homines are considered masculine, they have the second declension masculine ending. So it'd be second declension, accusative plural, ending in os. Homines, es, is third declension, accusative plural. And then the last thing we have in Italia. Italia here is going with in, which takes the ablative. And so you have that long mark again, and that would be first declension, ablative, singular. Number six, all the enemies feared the Romans. So we write it out in Latin. It would be omnes hostes Romanus timuerunt. So omnes hostes are both third declension. They're the subject, it's the thing that feared. So it'd be third declension, nominative plural endings, es, es. And then we have Romanos, which are second declension. That's what the enemies feared. So that's a direct object. So that's second declension, accusative plural. All right, let's look at the last one, number seven. Jupiter did not approve of the life of the king and destroyed the palace with a lightning bolt and killed the king. Wow. All right, so the sentence would be Jupiter vitam regius non probavit et regiam fulmina delavit et regem necavit. Now, Jupiter here is a weird third declension. It kind of changes all the place. It's the subject. Is this Jupiter? Nominative singular. Then we have vitam. That's the thing he did not approve of. So now it's first declension vita, and it has to go to am because it's accusative singular. Now, regis, we haven't really talked about the genitive yet, but regis is a genitive third declension, and it means of the king. And then non probavits are verb. And then we have another accusative because the thing, what did Jupiter destroy? He destroyed the palace. So regia, we go to regiam. First declension, accusative, singular. And then how did he do it? He did it with a lightning bolt. And we have that with there by means of. And so fulmine is a third declension, ablative, singular, ending in that E. And then the last thing, he killed the king, regem. So we're going to the third declension, and it's accusative, singular. And there we go. So please check your worksheet. Please correct. If you have any questions, email me. And good luck. All right. Valete omnes, lingua latina est vita.